Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to another class on linguistics. I hope I find you all in good health and cheer. And in the midst of this pandemic situation, I hope that you all are keeping well emotionally and physically. Although we can't meet each other and greet each other like we used to do, my good thoughts and prayers are always with you. So I hope that you all do well in the coming days. And that I keep up the hope that we can see each other pretty soon. So today I want to introduce you to American English. We have been learning linguistics, the scientific study of language. So any scientific study of language is incomplete without considering the variations or different varieties of language. So till now, the English that you have learned has been British English. So today I want to introduce you to American English, and I want to tell you what are the differences between British English and American English. So let us go on this journey together on American English. So English language, it was brought to America, the continent America, by colonists from England. So, Englandil nanna colonistukal 17th nootandil. They came to America in 17th century. They are called Pilgrim Fathers. You might have learned about this in history classes. So, they migrated to America in 17th century and they took English language with them. So, what was the language of America before that? There were many indigenous languages that were spoken in America. America was at that time inhabited by different tribal settlings. So these tribes, they spoke different varieties of languages. Today, those languages are not so popular in America. English has taken over most of the aspects of life there. There are only very few speakers of these native languages of America. So in the centuries that followed, after 17th century, British English and American English, they developed on independent lines. Rendu vazhikku develop cheyan thodangi. So there are certain marked differences between British English and American English. The differences are there in pronunciation. There are very marked differences in pronunciation between British and American English. Also vocabulary. There are some items in American English which are absent in British English. Also in spelling, grammar, morphology, semantics, all these respects, there are certain differences between British and American English. So I want to introduce you to each of these titles. So let's first deal with vocabulary. So we can see that the largest divergences between British English and American English, we can find these in vocabulary. So these colonists, they came and settled in this new country, this new continent, America. And there in America, they found new objects and new experiences in this continent. They did not have such objects and experiences back in England or back in Europe. So, they wanted new words to be given to these objects and experiences. So, they wanted to become acquainted with the physical features of this continent. So, regarding the physical features of the continent, a continent in the mottathilulla physical features vachu nokkumbodhekku avade avaru kanda pudhiya chila objects, experiences, adine aduvayittu bandhippikkan vendi avarku British English la vaakkukal illayirunnu. So, because there were no words in their language, or because the resources in British English was inadequate to refer to the new objects and experiences in the new continent, they developed a whole new series of words like bluff. Bluff means a small hill. Again, foothill notch, another word. Watershed, another word. Clearing. Clearing is something like this. The second picture, this is a picture of a clearing in the middle of a densely populated area with trees. You can see a place with no trees in between. സച്ച് എ പ്ലേസ് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് ക്ലിയറിംഗ്. മരങ്ങളൊക്കെ തിങ്ങി നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരു സ്ഥലത്ത് ഇടയ്ക്ക് മരങ്ങളില്ലാത്ത ഒരു പ്രദേശം കാണുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ക്ലിയറിംഗ്. അഗെയിൻ അണ്ടർ ബുഷ്, അണ്ടർ ബുഷ് ഇസ് അഗെയിൻ സ്മോൾ ഗ്രോത്ത്, ചെറുതായിട്ട് പുല്ലൊക്കെ പിടിച്ച് നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരു ഏരിയ, അതിന് അണ്ടർ ബുഷ് എന്ന് പറയും. സോ ലുക്ക് ഇൻ ദിസ് ഫേസ്റ്റ് പിക്ചർ, ദേർ ആർ സെർട്ടൻ അതർ വേർഡ്സ് ഫോർ അണ്ടർ ബുഷ് ലൈക്ക് അണ്ടർ ഗ്രോത്ത്, അണ്ടർ ബ്രഷ്, സ്ക്രബ്, ബ്രഷ്, അണ്ടർ വുഡ്, ബ്രാക്കൻ, ബ്രാംബിൾസ്, ബ്രയേഴ്സ്, ബ്രഷ് വുഡ് കവർ. സോ ഓൾ ദീസ് ആർ ദീസ് റെഫർ ടു സ്മോൾ ലൈക്ക് കുറ്റിക്കാട് എന്നൊക്കെ പറയത്തില്ലേ, അതുപോലത്തെ സംഭവങ്ങളാണ്. സോ ഇൻ ദിസ് ന്യൂ കോണ്ടിനെന്റ് ദീസ് കോളനീസ് ദേ എക്സ്പീരിയൻസ്ഡ് ന്യൂ ഒബ്ജെക്ട്സ് ആൻഡ് ന്യൂ എക്സ്പീരിയൻസസ്. ദേ ഡിഡ് നോട്ട് ഹാവ് വേർഡ്സ് ഇൻ ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ടു റെഫർ ടു ദീസ് ഒബ്ജെക്ട്സ് ആൻഡ് എക്സ്പീരിയൻസസ്. സോ ന്യൂ വേർഡ്സ് വെർ coined. So likewise, they encountered a lot of living and growing things in this new continent. In America, they saw a lot of living and growing things. So they did not have words in British English to refer to all these plants and animals and all. So what they did was they borrowed words from Indians. Not our Indians, Red Indians or Native Americans. So some of these words are moose. Moose is this animal. And then raccoon. Raccoon is this one. Skunk. You might have seen these in American movies. This looks very cute. It looks very cute. But it's actually a nasty animal. If you go too near it, it will actually spray you with stuff from its buttocks. And it smells so bad. So that is a skunk. And this is opossum. And this is a chipmunk. And porgy. This it's a kind of fish. Terrapin is a kind of turtle. And then mud and hen, you know about it. This is a garter snake. Garter snake is like a garden snake. It's not poisonous. And this is a bullfrog. And potato, you know about potato. Bug, also you know what bug is. And groundhog, this animal is a groundhog. So these animals, these living and growing things, these were new experiences for the colonists in America. They did not have adequate words in British English to refer to these animals and plants. So what they did was they borrowed names from Indian settlers. Likewise, the colonists had many contacts with Indians, means Native Americans. Okay, so they borrowed a number of words having peculiar reference to the Indian way of life. So these Indian way of life means at that point of time, Native Americans, the original people of America, they used to live in tribes. They had a different way of life. So all these items, they actually borrowed a number of words with close relationship to the Indian way of life. For example, wigwam. Wigwam is actually this kind of hut lived in by the Red Indians. And tomahawk is this axe, it's like a small axe. Canoe is this little boat. And toboggan. Is this kind of a sled. മഞ്ഞിലൊക്കെ സ്നോയിലൊക്കെ ഇങ്ങനെ സ്ലൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് നീങ്ങാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടുള്ളൊരു സാധനമാണ്. മാക്കിനോ ഇസ് എ സ്പെഷ്യൽ കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് കോട്ട്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി യൂസ്ഫുൾ ഡ്യൂറിങ് വിൻ്റർ. ആൻഡ് മോക്കസിൻ ഇസ് ദിസ് കൈൻഡ് ഓഫ് ഷൂസ് വിച്ച് ആർ ഹാൻഡ് മെയ്ഡ് ഷൂസ് യൂസ് ബൈ നേറ്റീവ് അമേരിക്കൻസ്. ആൻഡ് സ്കോ ആൻഡ് പപ്പൂസ്. സ്കോ ഇസ് അനദർ നെയിം ഫോർ എ വുമൺ. It's not that respectful to use that term now. And papoose is actually a little bag used to carry a child on your back. Pasko ennu parnal stree, papoose ennu parnal kunnine carry cheyanulla oru bag. It's usually made of fabric and some wood or something like that. So these are certain words which we borrowed from Indians, Red Indians. And these have a relation to the Indian way of life. Wigwam, tomahawk, canoe, toboggan, mackinaw, moccasin, scope, and papoose. Okay. And then there were a lot of things and experiences associated with a new way of life. So these colonists, they came to America. So they found themselves in a different kind of life. This was a new life. The geographical setting was different. The nature was entirely different. The experiences they had in the island was entirely different from what they had in England or in any other part of Europe. So they borrowed certain words, like they coined certain words like backcountry. Backcountry is this kind of a wilderness kind of space. You know, America is a very large country and most of this island is actually unpopulated. You can say that. Most of this country, you can find that it is in still in wilderness. So that is called backcountry. Backwoodsman is a person who lives in such a setting. Squatter is actually a person who is forced to move out of his setting. ഈ കോളനിസ്റ്റുകൾ വന്നപ്പോഴത്തേക്ക് അവരുടെ സ്ഥിരമായിട്ടുള്ള സ്ഥലങ്ങളിൽ നിന്ന് മാറി ഓടേണ്ടി വന്ന ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഓഫ് പീപ്പിളുണ്ട്. ദേ ആർ കോൾഡ് സ്ക്വാട്ടേഴ്സ്. ഇൻ മോഡേൺ ഏജ് സ്ക്വാട്ടേഴ്സ് ആർ കോൾഡ് ഹോംലെസ് പീപ്പിൾ. ദേ ഡോണ്ട് ഹാവ് ഹോം, സോ ദേ ജസ്റ്റ് ലിവ് ഓൺ ദ സൈഡ് ഓഫ് ദ റോഡ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾ. ഓൾസോ ദേ ലിവ് ഇൻ അൺഇൻഹാബിറ്റഡ് പ്ലേസസ്. ആളുകൾ ഉപേക്ഷിച്ചു പോയ വീടുകളിലൊക്കെ, ചെറിയ ചെറിയ കെട്ടിടങ്ങളിലൊക്കെ താമസിക്കുന്ന ആൾക്കാരെ സ്ക്വാട്ടേഴ്സ് എന്ന് വിളിക്കാറുണ്ട്. ദെൻ പ്രയറി ഇസ് സച്ച് എ പ്ലേസ് ഫിൽഡ് വിത്ത് ടോൾ ഗ്രാസ്. കോൾഡ് സ്നാപ്പ്, ഇഫ് യു ക്യാൻ സീ ദിസ് പിക്ചർ, കോൾഡ് സ്നാപ്പ് ഇസ് വെൻ റണ്ണിങ് വാട്ടർ ഫ്രീസസ് സഡൻലി. കോൾഡ് സ്നാപ്പ് ഇസ് വെരി ഡേഞ്ചറസ്. സ്നോ പ്ലോ, സ്നോ പ്ലോ ഇസ് എൻ ഇൻസ്ട്രുമെൻറ്റ് യൂസ് ടു മൂവ് സ്നോ ഫ്രം ദ റോഡ്സ്. You can see this is an old fashioned snowplow. Nowadays they have snowplow trucks and all. And bobsled and sleigh, this is another kind of, it's kind of like a slide, used to slide down the snow. There used to be competitions. There still are competitions for sleighing and all. So this is a bobsled and sleigh. So these are things associated with a new way of life. And then the colonists, they also got a number of words from other languages. So in addition to English colonists, there were also French colonists in America. French kaaril ninnu ivaru borrow cheytha korche words aanu pottage, chowder, cachet, pumpkin, caribou, bureau, bago, etc. So here I have the picture of chowder. Most of these words are words refer to domestic life and food and all. So chowder is a kind of a soupy kind of food. This is mostly made of seafood anyway. So from the Dutch colonists, they borrowed words like kruller, coleslaw, cookie, yankees, dope, sloop, boss, etc. So this is a coleslaw. This is a kind of salad made with cabbage and mayonnaise. And from German colonists, they borrowed words like noodle, pretzel, smearcase, etc. This is a pretzel. This is kind of like a bread. Usually it is supposed to be crispy, but I don't think this one is that crispy anyway. And in addition to that, we also have certain political terms in American English, like caucus. Caucus is when a group of politicians come together in agreement of something. Filibuster and carpetbagger are negative terms used in American politics. Then some names of drinks which we have in American English. These actually have been established in British English also now. Although it was first derived in American English. So these names are cocktail, coke. Coke means Coca-Cola, Applejack, etc. And then certain commercial words like Kleenex. Kleenex means tissue paper. Kodak, Vaseline, etc. All these were derived first in American English, but even nowadays, even in British English, these are used. So that brings us to the end of vocabulary items in American English. So let's move on to the next category in which we can find divergences between British and American English. So this field is called semantics. Semantics is that field of linguistics which deals with meaning. So In both British and American English, we have certain common words, but it will have different meaning in each of these languages. കോമൺ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ചില വേർഡ്സ് ഉണ്ടാവും, പക്ഷെ ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷിലുള്ള മീനിങ് ആയിരിക്കില്ല അമേരിക്കൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷിൽ ഉണ്ടാവുക. ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ, ദിസ് വേർഡ് സൊളിസിറ്റർ ഇൻ ബ്രിട്ടൻ മീൻസ് എ ലോയർ ഓർ എൻ അഡ്വക്കേറ്റ്. ഇൻ അമേരിക്കൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ദ സെയിം വേർഡ് മീൻസ് എ ക്യാൻവാസർ ഓർ എ വിസിറ്റിംഗ് ഏജന്റ്, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ പേഴ്സൺ ഹൂ ഇസ് ട്രൈങ് ടു സെൽ എ പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് ഓവർ ദ ഫോൺ ഓർ ഇൻ പേഴ്സൺ. ഡോർ ടു ഡോർ സെയിൽസ്മാനെയാണ് സൊളിസിറ്റർ എന്ന് വിളിക്കുന്നത്. In British English, a politician means a person who is engaged in politics. That same word in American English means any person who is an opportunist. Taram nokki perumaarunna oralayaanu politician ennu American English la vilikkunna, which is actually a negative term. In British English, public school actually means a privately owned school. Only rich people can attend such public schools in Britain. But in American English, that same term is existing in American English too. But in American English, public school means a government-funded school. So, opposite meanings. In British English, a clerk is a person who works in an office. A clerk is a person who works in an office. In American English, a clerk is a person who works in a shop. He or she will be a shop assistant. In British English, fall means falling down. In American English, fall means autumn season, when the leaves fall. So I hope you understood. These are the set of words which are common to British and American English, but they have different meaning in different in both these languages. So the next point is, there are certain objects in two languages, but they have different words in two languages. So there are different words in two languages which refer to the same object. For example, in Britain, a tram is called a streetcar in America. So a tram in Britain is called a streetcar in America. A lift in Britain is called an elevator in America. A goods train in Britain is called a freight train in America. A pavement in Britain is called a sidewalk in America, and in India it becomes a footpath. Guard in Britain becomes a conductor in America. Petrol in Britain becomes gasoline in America. Undertaker is a person who takes care of, who cremates, who is in charge of cremating and burying bodies, dead bodies. But that person becomes a mortician in America. Silencer in Britain becomes muffler in America. Railway in Britain becomes railroad in America. So those are the two points in semantics referring to meaning. Some words are common to British and American English, but they carry different meanings. There are same objects in both these languages, but they have different words. So that brings us to the end of semantics. So the next section is morphology. So word formation, these practices are mostly the same in British and American English. But Americans are actually very good at coining new compound words. These are some of the compound words coined by Americans. Words like highbrow, skyscraper, killjoy, etc. And they also, Americans are also very good at abbreviating. They have made short words like gas from gasoline, auto from automobile, movie from moving picture, etc. And again, in American English, they have a preference for en in forming past participle. Past participle undakkan vendi en aanu American English koodal prefer cheyyunnu. So they actually use stricken instead of struck. So that is peculiar about American English. The next category of difference between British English and American English is in regard to spelling. So let's go point by point here. So you know that Americans write favor, color, and many other words without U. The English people, the British English writes favor, F-A-V-O-U-R. But in America, it is written as F-A-V-O-R. So, without U in America, with U in Britain. Again, Americans use, in some words, they use only one consonant. Whereas in English, they write double consonants. For English, in American English, it is a traveler with one L. In Britain, it is a traveler with two L's. American wagon is with one G. British wagon is with two G's. Okay, so Americans use one consonant, whereas English people, they use double consonants in some words, not all words. So the third point is, in certain words, Americans write ER instead of RE. For example, words like meter, scepter, fiber, center, theater, etc. അപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള വേർഡ്സിലെല്ലാം അമേരിക്കൻസ് ഇ ആർ ആണ് യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ശരിക്കും ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷിൽ ആർ ഇ, എം ഇ ടി ആർ ഇ എന്നാണ് ബ്രിട്ടീഷ് ഇംഗ്ലീഷിൽ. അമേരിക്കൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷിൽ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എം ഇ ടി ഇ ആർ. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ തേർഡ് പോയിന്റ് ഓഫ് ഡിഫറൻസ് ഇൻ സ്പെല്ലിംഗ്. അഗെയിൻ ദ ഫോർത്ത് പോയിന്റ് ഇസ് അമേരിക്കൻസ് പ്രിഫർ എസ് ഇൻ വേർഡ്സ് ലൈക്ക് ഡിഫെൻസ്, ഒഫെൻസ് എക്സെട്ര. ഇഫ് യു കെൻ സീ ദിസ്, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഡി ഇ എഫ് ഇ എൻ എസ് ഇ. Whereas in British English, it is D-E-F-E-N-C-E. So, Americans prefer S, British prefer C in certain words. Again, look at the difference in spelling between these words. Axe in America is A-X, whereas in Britain, it is A-X-E. Plow in America is P-L-O-W. In Britain, it is P-L-O-U-G-H. In America, tire is spelled T-I-R-E. In Britain, tire is spelled T-Y-R-E. In America, story, that is a two-storied building, a three-storied building. So, story is spelled S-T-O-R-Y in America. And in Britain, they add an E in between, S-T-O-R-E-Y. In America, a czar is spelled T-S-A-R, whereas in Britain, czar is spelled C-Z-A-R. In American English, jail is spelled J-A-I-L, but the real British English spelling of jail is G-A-O-L. Actually, we have been using American English for this word, but the real British spelling is G-A-O-L. Again, the next point of difference in spelling is, for some words like check, mark, mask, etc., it's not mark, I'm sorry. In British English, check is spelled as C-H-E-Q-U-E. In American English, check is spelled as C-H-E-C-K. Americans are korchum kooda simple aayittulla spelling aanu British English ne kaattalum use cheyyunnu. Americans write C-H-E-C-K. Britishers write C-H-E-Q-U-E. So that is the difference in spelling between American and British English. I have tried to point some, I have tried to cover some points here. That is not all, but some of it. So let's discuss pronunciation now and how British and American English differs from each other in pronunciation. Let's look at these words. They are pronounced differently in both the languages. For example, in British English, these words are pronounced fast, path, grass, dance, can't, half. So it is pronounced using the vowel ah. In American English, the same words are pronounced fast, path, grass, dance, can't, half. So British English uses ah, American English uses a. The next point is about the treatment of r in English. British English la r ennu parayna alphabet pala idathum pronounce cheyyarilla. So in British English, r is silent except for when it occurs before a consonant. Except for when it occurs before a vowel, sorry. But in American English, R is pronounced in all positions. Okay, in British English, R is not pronounced in all positions. It is pronounced only when it occurs before vowels. Vowels in mumbu verimba matrame British English la R pronounce cheyarullu. American English la R ella positions lum pronounce cheyarund. Let's look at the third point now. Pronunciation of O. So in words like these, in British English, it is pronounced as lot, hot, top, not. So it is a very open O. It's pronounced lot, hot, top, not. But in American English, it is not pronounced as a round vowel much. It is pronounced as lat, hat, top, not. It's a little bit like A, but not completely like A. There's a subtle difference between the pronunciation in British English and American English. The next point is about the ER combination. ER combination in British English, it is pronounced as A. For example, word in place names like these. In British English, it is pronounced as Derby, Barclay, etc. It's Derby, Barclay. So in British English, it is pronounced as A. In American English, it is pronounced as A. It's pronounced Derby, Berkeley, etc. So, British English la Derby, American English la Derby, British English la Barclay, American English la Berkeley. Okay. So, in British English, words have one heavy stress, that is one primary stress, and several weak stresses. But in American English, there is one secondary stress or two. So that is why American speech is a little slower than English speech. American speech is actually, Britishers don't like the American way of speaking. They call it American drawl. Americans are slow aayittanu samsaarikkunnathu parney kaliyaakkarundu. Okay. And there is also a certain nasal tone associated with American pronunciation. Americans use nasal tones mostly. They use nose while pronouncing certain words. But at the same time, American pronunciation is generally closer to spelling. Spelling enganeyano ekadesham adhe pole ok pronounce cheyan Americans shramikkarundu. So that is the end of pronunciation lesson and the differences between British and American pronunciation. It's not all, but only a few points are discussed by us. Let's look at some differences in British and American grammar. In American English, we'll ask, do you have time? In British English, we'll ask, have you got time? American English asks, do you have time? British English asks, have you got time? And in American English, if you start a sentence with one, the subject is one, you can actually continue with he or his. For example, this is an example. If one loses his temper, he should apologize. So you see how, ivide one use edu, but after this you have used his and he. But in British English, if you use one, it should be like this. If one loses one's temper, one should apologize. Okay, American English is a little more flexible than British English is in that respect. Again, prepositions are different in British and American English. For example, in Britain, you live in Oxford Street. American lives on Oxford Street. And a British man caters for somebody. An American man caters to somebody. A British man talks to someone. An American man talks with someone. A British man is different from someone. An American man is different than someone. So you see how they use prepositions differently in both these languages. So let's see what are the dialects in American English. In comparison with British English, American English is, it maintains a high degree of uniformity. There are many different dialects in Britain, but in America, the number of dialects are actually lesser. The reason for this is the greater mobility of Americans. Americans actually keep traveling around in the continent. So that is a reason for the degree of uniformity. There are three main dialects in American English: Northern, Midland, and Southern. But in addition to that, there is another dialect can be noted, that is a New England dialect. So these are some words from these dialects. From Northern dialect, we have these words: white bread, poison ivy, and brook. Brook actually means a stream. From Midland dialect, we have this word armload. Armload means an arm full of wood. From Southern dialect, we have a word lightwood. Lightwood means firewood. And snap beans. Snap beans means string beans. String beans means നമ്മൾ തോരനൊക്കെ വെക്കാൻ എടുക്കുന്ന പയർ പോലെ നീളമുള്ള പയർ. Then a word from New England dialect is pigsty. Pigsty, പന്നിക്കൂട്. Pigsty is actually called pig pen in rest of America, but in New England dialect it is called a pigsty. So that is all about American dialects, and that actually brings us to the end of this lesson. I hope you really enjoyed learning about American English and its differences from British English, and I hope this class was beneficial to you and you enjoyed it thoroughly. Thank you for watching it till the end. Thank you so much for your attention. Have fun. Bye.